Okay, welcome friends. Now we'll discuss next part, that is a right circular cylinder. Right circular cylinder. Now what is meaning of right circular cylinder? Right circular cylinder is a surface generated by the straight lines. This is surface generated by the straight lines and whose distance is always constant, from a fixed line. This distance is always constant from a fixed line. Then this line is called axis. This constant distance is called radius of cylinder. Right circular cone is the surface generated by the straight lines whose distance is always constant from a fixed line. This fixed line is called axis of cylinder and this constant distance is called radius of cylinder. Now I will plot this figure in this way also. And this is your axis. Axis of cylinder. This distance is called radius of cylinder. This is radius of cylinder. Okay, this radius R is constant. R is constant means this radius is constant in between any generator and axis of the cone. This is same. Radius is always same. Then this cone is called right circular cone. Now we'll discuss how to find equation of a right circular cone. To find equation of right circular cylinder. Now again, to find out equation of right circular cylinder, we need three things. Number one, direction ratios of axis of cylinder. Number two, point on axis of cylinder. I will say A point, alpha, beta, gamma, and here direction ratios of cylinder L, M, N. Then third, radius of cylinder. R. Again, to find out equation of right circular cylinder, we need these three things, and using these three things, we can find equation of right circular cylinder. Direction ratios of cylinder, then point on axis of cylinder and radius of cylinder. Okay, again we'll check how we'll find this direction equation of cylinder by using this given data. We'll draw this figure. This is our axis whose direction ratios are LMN. Now I am taking here is point A, alpha, beta, gamma. Direction ratios of axis of cylinder is known. Point on axis of cylinder. Usually we have to take this point P on the cylinder, general point, arbitrary point I am taking XYZ, and this distance PM. PM distance is called radius of cylinder, R. Means all these three things are given. Using these three things we can find equation of right circular cylinder. Here I will join this. Again, to join this, we can find out here AP easily. AP distance is equal to under root of, by using distance formula, A and P, by using distance formula, we can find out this AP distance, x minus alpha square plus y minus beta square plus z minus gamma square. PM distance is always known. This is given, is your radius R. AP is calculated by using distance formula. Now AM, what is AM? This AM is nothing but, now this is our AM. This distance is AM. If I will take projection of this AM on axis, then we are getting here, this distance is AM. This distance AM is nothing but projection of this line AP on axis of a cylinder. Means I will write this AM is nothing but projection of AP on axis. Now this is projection, and for projection I will suppose this angle is theta and this is nothing but projection. If this angle is theta, then how will find out AP? Now this AM, AM is nothing but AP cosine theta, means this is equal to AP cos theta. AM is nothing but our AP cos theta. Now again, I will use how to find out this cos theta. Now what is cos theta? Cos theta is angle between this AP and AM. Now we have to find out angle between AP and AM. To find out angle between AP and AM, I will use again direction ratios of this AP. Direction ratios of AP are x minus alpha. Again, we have to find out this cosine theta, whose direction ratios of this AP are x minus alpha, y minus beta, z minus gamma, difference between coordinates, and this line AP, whose direction is this AM, this whose direction ratios are L, M, N. Then here cosine theta is L into x minus alpha plus M into y minus beta plus N into z minus gamma whole divided by under root of L square plus M square plus N square, in root x minus alpha square plus y minus beta square plus z minus gamma square. But this total term under root of is nothing but our AP. This is same, means I will replace this total term as AP, because this total term is AP. Now this AP and this AP get cancelled, means we are getting, which is equal to L into x minus alpha plus M into y minus beta plus N into z minus gamma whole divided by under root of L square plus M square plus N square. This is nothing but our AM. AM is projection of this AP on axis of a cylinder, which is AP cos theta. Using this formulation, we are getting AM is equal to LMN. These are the direction ratios of this axis, alpha, beta, gamma, and x, y, z. Using this, we can find out this AM as L into x minus alpha plus M into y minus beta plus N into z minus gamma divided by under root of L square plus M square plus N square. Using this, we can find out here equation of right circular cylinder by taking Pythagoras theorem, by using Pythagoras theorem in this triangle, and we get from right angle triangle AMP, we can write AP square is equal to AM square plus MP square. Using all these values in this formula, then we get equation of right circular cylinder. I will recall this once again. To find out equation of right circular cylinder, we must have direction ratios of axis of cylinder LMN. Here is point A, alpha, beta, gamma on axis of cylinder. This radius, we are taking P point, general point on cylinder. This radius PM is R, and using this right angle triangle, we will get equation of a right circular cylinder. Again, what is AP? AP equal to under root of x minus alpha square plus y minus beta square plus z minus gamma square. PM is radius R, and AM, this is important. What is AM? This is projection of AP on axis of cylinder. And how we are calculating this? L into x minus alpha plus M into y minus beta plus N into z minus gamma whole divided by under root of L square plus M square plus N square. This is our AM. Using these things, and we are using Pythagoras theorem in triangle AMP, this is AP square is equal to AM square plus MP square Putting all these values in this formula, then we get required equation of right circular cylinder. Okay, thank you. We'll continue problems in coming lectures.